ओके okay. आज वी आर गोइंग टू द स्ट्रेटजी के विच इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पोर्शन एंड वेरी ब्रॉड पोर्शन. तो नियरली 3, 4, 5 क्वेश्चन, आई मीन फ्लक्चुएट बिटवीन 3 to 5 क्वेश्चन एवरी ईयर दे आस्क फ्रॉम स्ट्रेटजी.
No, it's very mixed.
So, can anyone tell from which state this cultural and classical dance is popular? Mohini Attam and Kathak.
Kerala.
Kerala. Okay, good answer. So both of these belong to the Kerala. So rest of that we will read. So like Bharatanatyam, which is important in Tamil Nadu state, Manipuri dance in Manipur, Kathak is from UP, and Kathakali is from Kerala. So don't get confused.
Hello. Yes. Sir, good evening. Sir, ये कह रहा था कि आपकी क्लास डेली होती है? अच्छा अच्छा सर, तो स्टैटिक की सर फर्स्ट क्लास है?
दिस इज फर्स्ट क्लास ऑफ स्टैटिक. वी हैव कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल सिलेबस. वी हैव पुट ऑल द रिकॉर्डिंग इन आवर चैनल, यू कैन एक्सेस फ्रॉम देयर.
अच्छा अच्छा सर, थैंक यू सर.
यू कैन आस्क क्वेश्चन लेटर आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस.
ओके सर, थैंक यू थैंक यू.
सो कथक इज फ्रॉम नॉर्थ इंडिया यूपी. उड़ीसी इज अ डांस ऑफ उड़ीसा स्टेट. Kathakali is from Kerala. Mohini Attam is also from Kerala. So these two are from Kerala. Bihu. Bihu is a very popular dance in Assam. And Sattariya dance. These two dance are from Assam. Bihu and Sattariya, which is very famous there. Chau is a kind of tribal dance, which is also by other communities popular. But specifically in tribals, Chau. It is popular in Odisha, Jharkhand and West Bengal, primarily in Odisha, but as well as Jharkhand and West Bengal. Bhangra and Gidda, these two are famous in state of Punjab. Garba in Gujarat, Ghumar in Rajasthan, and Kuchipudi, which is famous in Andhra Pradesh as well as in Telangana. So both these, I mean Telugu region, this dance is famous. So you have to remember these 5-10 or nearly 10-12 classical dance, important dance. So you have to remember it with their states. Next is classical language. Has you people heard about the classical language in India?
Yes, sir.
How many classical language are there in which is recognized?
Six.
Okay, six. Which?
Sanskrit, Tamil, Telugu, and I don't remember more.
Malayalam, Kannad, Telugu, Tamil, Sanskrit, and I guess Odia.
Okay. All these six are classical language. So in India, we all know that there are 22 languages in our scheduled languages. Can anyone tell how much language were there originally? in constitution?
14.
Sir,
okay.
14.
And when
14
these,
languages.
Languages added?
21st Amendment, 15th language, Hindi was added. Then we had 71st Amendment, three more languages were added, Konkani, Manipuri and Nepali. Then the 92nd Amendment of the Constitution, four languages were added, Maithili, Santhali, Bodo and Dogri.
Okay, good. So through that, we reached 22 scheduled languages. So this 22 scheduled languages, Indian Constitution also recognized six languages collectively as a classical language. And what are the grounds to recognize as a classical languages? So they have made basically two grounds, that its record must date back to as many as 15 to 2000 years. So any classical language which have roots nearly 1500 to 2000 years back, I mean their roots means they are read there, or their literature are there, or they are written on stones or on leaves, something like that. As well as, and must be original and not borrowed from any other community. So they are the, I mean original, I mean evolved from their own places, and they are not borrowed most of the things, terms or grammar from any other language. So something like that, there are two categories to recognize classical language. So first classical language which was recognized was Tamil language in the year 2004, after that Sanskrit in the year of 2005, next is Kannada in the year of 2008, Telugu in 2008, Malayalam in 2013, and Odia in 2014. So these six languages were recognized. Last one was Odia, which was recognized in 2014, and Tamil was the first in 2004. So basically, Malayalam and Odia are not that much older comparison to Tamil and Sanskrit, but still they have their roots nearly more than 1000 years, and they have literatures. So on that ground, they were recognized as the classical language. Now we will move to the major rivers in India. So today I don't have tab, otherwise I would have highlighted it proper. But can you people see the cursor? Cursor aap logon ko dikh raha hai mera?
Yes, okay. Sir.
So focus on that. I will point that, and I will try to teach all the things through these maps. So can anyone tell which is the longest river in India? No.
Brahmaputra?
In India.
Ganga.
In India, whenever question Ganga. Come, then we will go Ganga. With the Ganga. Even though Brahmaputra and Indus both are larger than Ganga, but they are not completely in India. They start from the Tibetan region of China and then India, then other like Indus go to the Pakistan through Kashmir, and Bhutan start from Tibet, enters in India, then goes through Bangladesh. So largest river of India is Ganga. So Ganga is the one of the most important river of North India, and its important tributary are Yamuna, Ghagra, Gandhak, Gomti, Chambal, Betwa, San. These are the important, I mean, tributaries. So basically we have to remember the Ganga is the largest river of our country. I accept that Brahmaputra and Indus is the largest. They are also going through some part of our country. Like this Indus River goes through the, as you can see cursor here, goes through the Ladakh and Jammu Kashmir region of our country. Then it enters into Pakistan, then through Pakistan, Punjab and Sindh, it goes to the Arabian Sea. And Brahmaputra enters into Arunachal Pradesh, then Assam, then enters into Bangladesh, and after that in Bay of Bengal. So these are the important rivers of North India. Now we will come to the South India. So first you will come, then you will see the mountains. We will also read the mountains in the next coming slide, then you will have better understanding. So Narmada and Tapi, these are two important rivers which originate from state of Madhya Pradesh. From the Aravali, sorry, not Aravali, from the Vindhyas and Satpura. So you can see Narmada River is here. एंड देन नेक्स्ट रिवर इज तापी, इट इज ऑल्सो समवॉट पैरेलल टू द नर्मदा रिवर. तो नर्मदा इज द वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट रिवर इन आवर कंट्री. एंड माही यू कैन सी हियर इट ऑल्सो ओरिजिनेट इन मध्य प्रदेश देन गोज टू द अरबियन सी. साबरमती यू कैन सी ओरिजिनेट्स इन अरावली रेंज देन इंटर इन गुजरात देन गो टू अरबियन सी. सो दीज आर दी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट रिवर विच गोज टू द अरबियन सी नॉट द बे ऑफ बंगाल. सो समटाइम क्वेश्चन कम लाइक दैट विच ऑफ दीज रिवर विच फॉल इन द अरबियन सी. सो इफ दीज कम दीज फोर रिवर्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट एक्सेप्ट दैट थ्री मोर रिवर्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट विच आर नॉट हाईलाइटेड विच बिलोंग टू द केरला. वन इज पेरियार एंड वन इज द भारतपुत्र एंड एंड अनदर रिवर आई एम मिसिंग सम वॉट हिज नेम, इट्स नेम इज पंबा. सो वी विल ऑल्सो रीड अबाउट इट एंड आई विल शो यू ऑन दिस स्लाइड. सो दीज आर दिस सम रिवर विच फॉल्स इन द अरेबियन सी. नाउ वी विल मूव टू द साउथ इंडिया. So in South India, can anyone tell which is known as the Ganga of South India? Which river? Which river known as Ganga of South India?
Godavari.
Yes.
Godavari.
Yes, it's Godavari, which is called Ganga of South India. So Godavari, because it is one of the longest river as well as cover the large area. So Godavari. Then important river is Krishna, then Kaveri, and some small rivers like Pennar, Palar, and Ponyar. These three rivers are between Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. So these rivers go to the Bay of Bengal. So now once we will properly read which river flows which side. So the major ईस्ट फ्लोइंग रिवर्स आर विच ईस्ट फ्लोइंग मतलब जो बे ऑफ बंगाल में जाके मर्ज होता है. सो दे आर गंगा, ब्रह्मपुत्रा, गोदावरी, कृष्णा, कावेरी, महानदी. सो महानदी इज बेसिकली हेयर, आई फॉरगॉट टू मेंशन, महानदी इज हेयर. इट स्टार्ट इन छत्तीसगढ़ देन मूव टू द उड़ीसा एंड देन इंटर्स इन टू द बे ऑफ बंगाल. And Brahmani, a river which originates in North Chhattisgarh, then enters into Odisha. And this Subarnarekha starts from Jharkhand and enters into Bay of Bengal. Mahanadi, Pennar, Palar, Subarnarekha, Brahmani, Ponyar, Vaigai is an important river in Tamil Nadu. These are the important river which goes to the, enters in the Bay of Bengal. Now we will move to the west flowing river which enters into Arabian Sea. So first is Indus, Narmada, Tapti, Sabarmati, Mahi and Luni. Luni rivers is a river in our country which starts from the near Arauli region, but it finally ends in the this Rajasthan and Sindh, Pakistan Sindh border. So ये किसी rivers में जाके sorry किसी sea में जाके नहीं मिलती है. Luni river doesn't enter in a sea. So it goes and then dry up. उसके बाद सूख जाता है, dry हो जाता है. So that the Luni river. Then Mahadevi, Sharavati, Mahadevi is a वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिवर इन द स्टेट ऑफ गोवा. तो गोवा का लाइफ लाइन भी ऑल्सो कॉल इट लाइफ लाइन ऑफ गोवा, महादेवी. देन श्रावती, श्रावती इज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट रिवर इन कर्नाटका विच फ्लोज इन अरबियन सी. देन पंबा, भारतपुजा एंड पेरियार, दीज थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट रिवर आर फ्रॉम स्टेट ऑफ केरला विच मर्ज इन द अरबियन सी. सो दीज आर द रिवर विच आर इम्पॉर्टेंट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. Is from static GK. Last year there was question asked that which river merged in the Arabian Sea, and the correct answer was there Periyar River. So you have to remember all these names and beside they merge. Next we will go to with the mountain ranges. So, can anyone tell how many ranges Himalayan mountain have?
थ्री
हाँ, कैन यू नेम दैट?
हिमाद्री, हिमाचल, शिवालिक.
ओके, सो फ्रॉम इंडियन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू व्हेन वी सी वी काउंट थ्री, बट इफ यू विल लुक देयर आर फोर. वन इज दी ट्रांस हिमालया. ट्रांस हिमालया मेन पार्ट इज बेसिकली इन सम इन लद्दाख, सम इन तिब्बत एंड देन समथिंग लाइक दैट इन दैट रेंज. दैट इज नोन एज ट्रांस हिमालया. आफ्टर दैट कम दी हिमाद्री विच वी कॉल ग्रेटर हिमालया. सो इज इट समवेयर हेयर, आई मीन टचेज सम एरिया ऑफ लद्दाख एज वेल एज अरुणाचल प्रदेश. देन कम्स दी हिमाचल which called the lesser Himalaya. So this Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand, these regions are situated on that, and Nepal areas are on this Himalayan, Himachal range. Then Shivalik range. Shivalik range you can see. So my hometown is here somewhere here near this place, district Balrampur. So from there you can see the Shivalik ranges from your naked eye. So these are the important four ranges are Himalayan mountain, Trans Himalaya, then Himadri, Greater Himalaya, then Himachal, Lesser Himalaya, and then Shivalik range. And if you will go to the Meghalaya, there are three important hills. One is Garo, then Khasi, then Jayantia. These three are important separate Himalayas. Oh, sorry, not Himalaya. Separate three mountains in this Meghalaya region. This Purvanchal range is also part of Himalaya, and also these ranges you can say these are the part of the Himalayan. Karakoram range, Janskar range, Pir Panjal range, Shivalik range. So you don't have to remember that much, but at least the important ranges of Himalaya. What I have told you, four ranges. Next come the Aravali. So Aravali you can see start from the south of Delhi and it goes till the Rajasthan Gujarat border here. So something like that, the Aravali hill you can see. Then in central India, Madhya Pradesh, you can see the two ranges, Vindhyas range and after that Satpura range. So these are the two important range of this central India. Then Deccan region starts in this. There are some ranges which are not mentioned here. Then Palakonda range. Then comes the Nilgiri hills. Nilgiri is the connecting point of Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat. So what are these Western Ghat? So Western Ghat is a kind of line of the small hills which start from here from the Gujarat Maharashtra border and it's end till the here Kerala. It goes to the, so Eastern Ghat and Western Ghat both merge at Nilgiri hill. So these both, I mean small ranges from here and here come and meet at the Nilgiri hill. So remember that Nilgiri is the jointing point of these Ghats. Then Annamalai and Cardamom hills, these are the two important hills. In Annamalai is in Tamil and Cardamom is in Kerala and Tamil. So these are the some important ranges which you have to remember. Then comes the Niti Aayog. So last time there was a question asked that Prime Minister is the chairperson of the Niti Aayog, and it has given the defense minister is the ex officio member. And question was that first statement is correct, both statement is correct, or something like that. I mean none of the statement is correct, or second statement is only correct. So there was a question like that. So if you will have the understanding, then you can solve that. So Niti Aayog basically replaced the planning commission. Planning commission was which was established in 1950s. And then Niti Aayog came by replacing it on 1st January 2015. विद द अप्रोच ऑफ द बॉटम अप अप्रोच, मतलब नीचे से ऊपर की तरफ लेके जाने का अप्रोच, समथिंग लाइक दैट. एंड इट इज एन एक्स्ट्रा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम वेयर द आइडिया ऑफ प्लानिंग कमीशन टूक बाय आवर गवर्नमेंट.
Russia.
That time it was USSR. So the idea of planning commission came from the USSR. And can anyone tell what is this extra constitutional body? How many?
Which is not mentioned in the constitution.
Okay. How many kinds of bodies are there in our country? कितने टाइप के बॉडीज हैं इन इंडिया?
कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी, स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी.
सॉरी, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी,
स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी,
स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी एंड एक्स्ट्रा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल.
कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल, एक्स्ट्रा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल और स्टैट्यूटरी.
ओके, सो आई एम गिविंग यू सम नेम, सो यू हैव टू टेल मी विच काइंड ऑफ बॉडी इट इज. ओके
ओके सर.
माइनॉरिटी कमीशन,
एक्स्ट्रा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल,
स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी, स्टैट्यूटरी.
ओके, वुमेन कमीशन,
स्टैट्यूटरी.
ओके, इलेक्शन कमीशन,
कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल
बॉडी.
ओके, इंफॉर्मेशन कमीशन, इंफॉर्मेशन कमीशन इज स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर देर आर थ्री काइंड ऑफ बॉडी, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी, स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी एंड एक्स्ट्रा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी. एक्स्ट्रा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल बॉडी आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मीन्स विच आर मेंशन्ड इन आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन समवेयर इन सम आर्टिकल. एंड दिस स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी इज मेड बाई लॉ आवर पार्लियामेंट, लोकसभा एंड राज्यसभा. And extra constitutional are which are made by our cabinet. Neither they are mentioned in our constitution, nor they are formed by the parliament, but they are only made by our cabinet. So we have the cabinet ministers, they have their own cabinet, and through that, that is made. That is known as extra constitutional. So Niti Aayog is the extra constitutional, and earlier planning commission was also an extra constitutional body. So currently Suman Beri is the vice chairperson of Niti Aayog, and their status is the cabinet minister status in our country. And prime minister, Prime Minister of Prime Minister is chairperson of the Niti Aayog. One minute. Okay. So I was telling that Prime Minister is the chairperson of Niti Aayog, and recently Chief Executive Officer of Niti Aayog has changed. Yesterday I read in news, so Amitabh Kant finally left. So I will update it and it is sent to you. So recently new person is somebody is mentioned here, Parmasuram Iyer. So became the new chief executive officer of Niti Aayog. I read that, but I forgot to edit here. So I will edit it and I will then I will send you. Then chief minister and all the lieutenant governors of union territories are the governing council member of the Niti Aayog. So that's why it is called the bottom up approach. Earlier planning commission आई यूज टू आई मीन विदाउट टेकिंग एनी ओपिनियन फ्रॉम द चीफ मिनिस्टर एंड लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर दे डिसाइडेड एंड फ्रेमिंग द पॉलिसीज ऑफ कंट्री. नाउ चीफ मिनिस्टर्स ऑल ऑल्सो हैव सम से इन दिस. देन देयर आर द फोर एक्स ऑफिसो मेंबर्स. क्लियरली देयर इज मेंशन दैट देयर वुड बी ओनली फोर नॉट मोर देन दैट एक्स ऑफिसो मेंबर्स. सो करेंटली द एक्स ऑफिसो मेंबर्स आर द राजनाथ सिंह विच इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ डिफेंस, अमित शाह विच इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ होम अफेयर्स एज वेल एज कॉरपोरेट अफेयर, नॉट कॉरपोरेट अफेयर, कोऑपरेटिव मिनिस्टर ऑफ कोऑपरेशन. देन निर्मला सीतारमन मिनिस्टर ऑफ फाइनेंस एंड कॉरपोरेट अफेयर्स. देन नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर विच इज करेंटली मिनिस्टर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर वेलफेयर. सो दीज आर द फोर एक्स ऑफिसो मेंबर्स ऑफ द नीति आयोग. सो यू हैव टू ऑल्सो रिमेंबर देयर नेम्स. एंड दे ऑल्सो took two members, expert members from any institute or college. So that is not that much important. So I haven't mentioned here. So I was telling. So basically these are the information you have to remember. And if question will come, they will ask something from here. Then major revolutions happened in the world. So one question was there last year that when Russian Revolution happened. Can anyone tell?
1917.
Okay, and when American Revolution happened?
1776.
Okay, and when French Revolution happened?
1789.
Okay, nice. And when Chinese Revolution happened?
1911.
Okay, so there are two Chinese Revolution. We will read both. So, and can anyone tell where this glorious revolution happened?
America.
No, we are
sir, England. Sir, England.
I have already England. American. So, glorious revolution basically happened in the UK. Currently we call it UK, England. So it basically happened in England. It is also known as Orange Revolution. So I forgot to mention here, I will edit and send. So Glorious Revolution or Orange Revolution. So it happened in 1688. So basically that time in 1688, finally there was a bloodbath civil war happened in England. After that their king which accepted that they will make a parliament and somewhat it would be governed by that. So here it didn't happen any bloodbath in Glorious Revolution, but before that there was a major civil war in the 17th century. And after that American Revolution happened, which started from 1765 and continued to 1783. But if you will select a year, single year, then it is 1776. Next is the French Revolution, which started from 1789 and continued till 1799. So important year is 1789. Russian Revolution happened in 1917 and it is also known as, it is famous with one another name, Russian Revolution. Can anyone tell? That is October Revolution. Russian Revolution is also famous as October Revolution because it happened in month of October. Then Chinese Revolution. So Chinese Revolution, in China two major revolution happened. In 1911 finally their monarch has left the government and given the power to the some public which are some organization under the leadership of Sun Yat-sen. Then Chinese Revolution happened, Chinese Communist Revolution happened in 1949, and finally from which government was set up in 1911 under the leadership of Mao Zedong or Mao Zedong, they captured the power and Communist government established in 1949. So these two revolutions happened in China. देन क्यूबन रिवोल्यूशन, क्यूबन रिवोल्यूशन बेसिकली अमेरिका कॉलोनाइज्ड द कैरेबियन रीजन एज वेल एज द क्यूबा. सो फाइनली क्यूबन रिवोल्यूशनरी लीडर, कैन एनीवन टेल क्यूबन रिवोल्यूशनरी लीडर?
फिडेल कास्ट्रो.
फिडेल कास्ट्रो एंड चे गुवेरा वर द मेजर लीडर्स फ्रॉम देयर. सो दे स्टार्टेड इन 1953, कंटिन्यूड टिल 1950 एंड दे थ्रू आउट द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंपीरियल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ यूएसए. देन ईरानियन रिवोल्यूशन इन ईरान, देयर शाह ऑफ ईरान वॉज रिलिंग, शाह मीन्स रूलर किंग, सो शाह ऑफ ईरान वॉज रिलिंग दिस एंड इन 1978 अ रिवोल्यूशन हैपेंड ऑल्सो नोन एज इस्लामिक रिवोल्यूशन और वाइट रिवोल्यूशन. सो फाइनली दे इस्टेब्लिश द इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट विच आर करेंटली सेट अप देयर इन ईरान. सो दीज आर द मेजर रिवोल्यूशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड विच हैव टू रिमेंबर एंड हैव सम आइडिया. नेक्स्ट द इम्पॉर्टेंट इवेंट ऑफ द इंडियन नेशनल मूवमेंट. सो माइट बी दे आस्क सम क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम हेयर. दीज आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट ईयर इन विच सम मेजर मोमेंट्स हैपेंड विच फ्रेम्ड आवर होल हिस्ट्री ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया. सो इन 1857 अ मेजर रिवोल्ट हैपेंड एंड सम ऑफ द स्कॉलर्स एक्सेप्ट इज एज फर्स्ट वॉर ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस, बट इवन देयर इज अ डिबेट बिटवीन स्कॉलर. सम स्कॉलर डू नॉट एक्सेप्ट इट एज अ फर्स्ट वॉर ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस. सो देयर आर द रीजन वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू डिबेट, बट इफ समथिंग लाइक कम फर्स्ट वॉर ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस, रिमेंबर द 1857 रिवोल्ट विच हैपेंड इन नॉर्थ इंडिया मेनली. देन 1885 वॉज द ईयर ऑफ इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस एंड इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस वॉज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉलिटिकल पार्टी और इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच लेड द आवर दिस इंडिपेंडेंस मोमेंट. देन इन 1905 स्वदेशी आंदोलन हैपेंड एंड कैन एनी वन टेल वेयर दिस स्वदेशी आंदोलन हैपेंड इन 1905? एनी वन हैव रेड हिस्ट्री हेयर?
बंगाल.
हाँ ओके. सो इट बेसिकली हैपेंड इन बंगाल एंड व्हाई इट हैपेंड? इफ यू विल रीड हिस्ट्री यू विल गेट टू नो दैट बंगाल वाज वन ऑफ द मेजर हब ऑफ द रिवोल्यूशनरी लीडर्स एंड द लीडर्स फ्रॉम द आईएनसी एंड देयर यूनिटी बिटवीन हिंदू एंड मुस्लिम वाज वेरी स्ट्रांग and they were to against the colonial government. So for so dividing them under the division and rule policy, they divided the Bengal into two parts. One is the Bengali speaking and another side the Hindi speaking, because earlier Bengal was a very broad region. Current Bihar, Jharkhand, Odisha, West Bengal, Bangladesh, Assam, these were all part of the Bengal province. So they have divided one side which was the Muslim majority and Bengali speaking and another side the Hindu majority and Hindi speaking. So something like that they have divided it and they have grounded for the administrative region, but their region was to divide the unity. So against that in 1905 Swadeshi Andolan had started. So there were some major region major leaders of this Swadeshi Andolan like can anyone tell any name?
Sir, can you please repeat?
Sorry?
Could you please repeat?
Lal Bal Pal, have you heard?
Yes.
They were the extremist leader of
Lal Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and one more.
Bipin Chandra Pal.
Bipin Chandra Pal.
So these were the important leader at during that time. Then start the 1920 non-cooperation movement which was led by the Mahatma Gandhi. So this was one of the important moment in which Indians have decided, and in this Gandhi have told that if India will continue the movement for 2-3 years, then India will become independent, something like that. He assured to the people, and people wholeheartedly participated in this. I mean, there were large chunk of Muslims, Hindus, workers, farmers, women, these all participated in this Indian National Congress, given the call for this movement of non-cooperation movement. So in you can understand the movement by its name. I mean, they will not cooperate with, they will not wear the clothes made up by the British industry. They will not, I mean, go to the colleges of British. So if you will read history, you will get to know that there were some major institutes were set up from the non-cooperation movement. And Jamia Millia Islamia, which is in New Delhi, it is the product of non-cooperation movement. And Gandhian and other leaders of that time played major role to set up the Jamia Millia Islamia, Kashi Vidyapeeth and Gujarat Vidyapeeth. And there was another in Bihar. So these three, four major universities which are nowadays, so they were set up in the non-cooperation movement. If you will go to the history, you will get to know. Then in 1930 start the civil disobedience movement. In civil so how non-cooperation movement and kaise non-cooperation movement khatam hua? Chauri Chaura event, there is in Gorakhpur, where some people were became very angry by the torture of the police, and they burned whole the police station, and some of the police were burned and died. So on that ground, Gandhi took back the this Andolan, non-cooperation movement. Next is civil disobedience. Civil disobedience are basically opposing. And why they start the civil disobedience? Because they were at the time demanding that they should allow to make their own constitution. Can anyone tell who was the person who first put the idea of this constitution?
M.N. Roy.
And even this is asked in one of our previous question in our dual LLB entrance. So M.N. Roy given this idea, and after that Motilal Nehru, father of Jawaharlal Nehru, and other leaders wholeheartedly worked on that to frame their own constitution. And so they didn't accept. Even Simon Commission came to make some reform the current system which was going on. So Britishers didn't accept the India's proposal of making the constitution by the Indian. So on that ground, the civil disobedience movement started. Next is the Quit India movement, which happened in 1942. So you people have heard about the very famous slogan of Gandhi, do or die. So that slogan came from here, from this 1942 Quit India movement. So this was basically to free India finally, and give the people, I mean, because Britishers were asking to participate Indians in the World War, and they and Britishers also said that we will make some power to the Indians after they will cooperate in World War, and after war will end. So but Indians were not ready. Indians said that first you will give us power, then we will cooperate with us. So on that ground, something like 1942, a Quit India movement, which is was very non-violent kind of movement happened. One of the very non-violent kind of movement happened of Gandhian movement. Then finally in 1946, Constituent Assembly was framed, and Jawaharlal Nehru was made the Vice President first, then after that Prime Minister. So something like that is some important Indian National Movement you have to remember. Can anyone tell which organization is made by or led by the नेताजी सुभाष चंद्र बोस
फॉरवर्ड ब्लॉक
हाँ वन इज फॉरवर्ड ब्लॉक एंड
इंडियन
नेशनल आर्मी INA हाँ सो रिमेम्बर दैट नेक्स्ट इज स्टेट्स एंड इट्स कैपिटल सो दे बेसिकली डू नॉट आस्क फ्रॉम द मेजर इम्पॉर्टेंट स्टेट्स और विच आर द मोस्ट डिस्कस्ड स्टेट्स इन आवर फ्रॉम रीजन सो दे विल आस्क फ्रॉम द स्मॉलर स्टेट विच वी यूजली मिस टू रिमेंबर लाइक अरुणाचल प्रदेश इट्स कैपिटल इज ईटानगर आंध्र प्रदेश आर न्यूली कैपिटल इज अमरावती आसाम विच कैपिटल इज दिसपुर मेनी पीपल कन्फ्यूज इट विद गुवाहाटी गुवाहाटी इज वेरी प्रोमिनेंट सिटी ऑफ आसाम बट इट्स कैपिटल इज दिसपुर एंड दिस ऑल बिहार छत्तीसगढ़ ऑल पीपल नो देयर कैपिटल गोवा विच इज विच कैपिटल इज पणजी देन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर श्रीनगर इन समर एंड जम्मू इन विंटर and Kerala's capital is Trivandrum then Manipur its capital is Imphal so basically focus over the northeastern states and the smaller states like Goa Meghalaya Shillong Mizoram Aizawl Nagaland Kohima Odisha Bhubaneswar Sikkim Gangtok Tripura Agartala So can anyone tell the capital of Lakshadweep?
Kavarathi.
Lakshadweep capital is Kavarathi. And where is Andaman Nicobar's capital?
Port Blair.
So you can see Andaman and Nicobar its capital is Port Blair. Chandigarh is Chandigarh. Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Now Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu are merged and its capital is Daman. So I will also edit here and its capital is Daman. Then Ladakh, its capital is Leh. Lakshadweep, Karavati, Puducherry, its capital is Puducherry. Now we will go to the first cabinet of independent India. So in last year there was a question given on statement which that first home minister was Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel and first law minister was the B.R. Ambedkar. So first statement is true, both statement is true, second statement is true or none of them are true. So something like that question came. So you have to remember their important portfolios and who were the minister at that time. So Jawaharlal Nehru was Prime Minister as well as the Minister of External Affairs means Foreign Minister and Commonwealth Relations as well as Minister of Scientific Research. Then come Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. So he was our Deputy Prime Minister. Most people don't know that he was the Deputy Prime Minister. They only remember him as a Home Minister. But he was also the Deputy Prime Minister, Home Minister, Home Affairs and States, Minister of Information and Broadcasting. So these three important portfolios were under him. Then Minister of Finance, R.K. Shanmugam Chetty. So first he was that and then John Mathai, which was the Railway Minister and Transport, he later became the finance minister and he was served many years he has served many years then minister of law was B.R. Ambedkar minister of defense Baldev Singh minister of education Abul Kalam Azad then minister of food and agriculture was Rajendra Prasad minister of industries and supplies Shyama Prasad Mukherjee we all know later Rajendra Prasad became the president. Minister of Labour, Jagjivan Ram. Minister of Commerce, C.H. Bhabha. He was a Parsi trader and leader. Minister of Communication, रफी अहमद किदवई. मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ वॉज अमृत कौर. सो सी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वूमेन. सी वॉज द ओनली वूमेन इन द कैबिनेट एंड सी वॉज होल्डिंग द मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ. सो प्लीज रिमेंबर हर नेम. देन मिनिस्टर ऑफ वर्क्स माइंड्स एंड पावर वॉज द एन बी गाडगिल. देन मिनिस्टर ऑफ रिलीफ एंड रिहेबिलेशन वॉज के सी नियोगी. सो वाई देर वॉज अ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रिलीफ एंड रिहेबिलेशन ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम. Partition happened that time and lots of people were going from here and there and there was refugee crisis. So to deal that there was a ministry like this. Minister of Relief and Rehabilitation was K.C. Newton. And there were two ministers which were without portfolio. Now we will move the cryptocurrency blockchain and we will end our class here after this. So cryptocurrency, Bitcoin and blockchain was currently in news whole time. So you have to have some idea about it. Cryptocurrency is something which a form of currency which exists digitally as well as virtually or virtually. And uses cryptography to secure the transaction. So their transaction happened through a cryptography. So in that it you cannot tell who has sent to whom, but you can trace that who has sent from which place to which place and how much to one from one place to another place. So it is kind of recorded thing. So you no one can erase it. So cryptocurrency do not have central issuing or regulation authority. Means कोई भी किसी not from any country central authority or central government or central bank has issued it. It is decentralized basically. I mean through by the people. I mean some people have made it and they made it popular and now everybody can access that. So it is basically decentralized. Not regulated by any central agencies and it is supported by the peer to peer decentralized network called blockchain, jise hum blockchain kehte hain basically. So some important facts which are remembered. El Salvador was the first country who made the Bitcoin as legal tender. So in El Salvador, this Bitcoin is a legal tender. Can anyone tell where is this country, El Salvador?
Central America.
It is in Central America, a small country. Then is the Central African Republic, which became the second country which make it as a legal tender. So these two countries are important to remember. And Central African country make it recently, I mean 2 months back, I think, make it as a legal tender. And in our budget, union budget this year in 2022-2023, India has proposed to introduce a digital currency in the coming financial year. So means in next year India might be come with some digital currency, and currently India is putting 30% tax on the digital currency. So these are the some important facts which we have to remember. And important cryptocurrencies are Bitcoin, Ethereum, Ripple. So these are the important cryptocurrencies which are known to everybody. So from where this Bitcoin came? Bitcoin was introduced in 2009 and it is a open source protocol and is not issued by any central authority. So who has created this Bitcoin? A identity which is named as Satoshi Nakamoto. So this name is actually Japanese, but don't know who is this person or it is a person or any organization, nobody knows. So this identity only we name this name that this person has made, but we don't know this is a boy or girl or an organization. And conceptualize an accounting system aftermath of the 2008 financial crisis. So 2008 mein we all know there was a financial crisis, and after that this concept of Bitcoin came in year 2009. So we have to these information regarding the cryptocurrency. So now our static GK for today ends here. In next class I have made some list and I will prepare some more slides on that. So we will try to cover up to some extent because GK statics is a very broad, we cannot go through all, but we will touch which is relevant for our entrance. So is there anyone having any doubt?
Sir, iski PDF milegi kya?
Haan, of course iski PDF milegi.